8 years ago, in my second year in medical school, one of the subjects I was supposed to learn was the upper extremity. And so I took my clinical oriented anatomy textbook and I counted the number of pages that I was supposed to read. And it was 175 pages to learn the upper extremity. Now, prior to that time, I'd never read up to 10 pages of the clinical oriented anatomy in a day. That was when I knew there was a problem. Hello guys, and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Dr. Peter. My friends call me Dr. Piro. I'm a medical doctor and content creator currently working in Nigeria. And in this video, I want to talk about digital learning aids that you can use to learn medicine. The goal of this channel is to make your transition from medical school to clinical practice as smooth as possible, while you smash your exams in medical school and then transmute as smooth as possible without any hitches. I knew there was a problem because I'd never read 10 pages of Kismol before, and I had to read 17 pages 10 days in a row to be able to have an understanding of the upper extremity. And the upper extremity was just 15% of the work volume for, you know, the second part of my 200 level second year. So I knew there was a problem. It was at that point that I found Professor Robert Acklands. Now, Professor Robert Acklands has a very beautiful collection, a human atlas video that can help you learn anatomy in a jiffy. And it was just because of that I was able to complete my study of the upper extremity. And in this video, we're going to discuss, you know, various medical learning aids that are available online that you can use, and then which subject is most appropriate for you to use them. So off the bat, let's talk about Professor Robert Acklands' video atlas. It's designed for anatomy, and it gives you a comprehensive understanding, a concise and comprehensive understanding of the various sections of the human body. So there is a video dedicated for the upper extremities, the lower extremities, the trunk, and then there's a video for the head and neck, and then neuroanatomy. The advantages of Professor Robert Acklands' video is brevity. So in 2 hours, you can have an understanding, a thorough understanding of the human, of the upper extremity, for example. Now, I must tell you that since it's 2 hours, it's actually very dense, and you have to take your time to, you know, sort out the information by, you know, watching them playing various sections over and over again. But it beats reading 175 pages of clinical oriented anatomy. And if you read all 175 pages of the clinical oriented anatomy, you will forget most of the information. But by the time you see in 3D the brachial plexus and the elbow joint and the carpal tunnel, it's harder to forget that way. You know, I remember almost 20 years ago in the 2002 Korea-Japan World Cup, I can remember Cafu lifting the trophy after winning the World Cup. And I can remember it so clearly, even though I watched it on the black and white TV. I believe visual aids are very important in learning medicine. You can stay all day poring on your embryology textbook, wondering how the 3 germ layers, you know, turn and fold to form a hollow embryo. Or you can watch a 3D representation online that will give you an understanding and a good way to remember, you know, your anatomy stuff. So Professor Robert Acklands, human anatomy. The advantages are brevity, as I've said earlier. However, the disadvantage, I would say, would be it's majorly for gross anatomy. So histology and embryology would actually be on the back burner when it comes to Professor Robert Acklands' video atlas. Also, another downside would be the fact that it does not follow the traditional orientation when it comes to anatomy. So if you are a student that takes notes, and everybody should take notes, you can tailor your notes to suit a particular outline for the various subject that he's going to be discussing in the video atlas. But however, Professor Robert Acklands' atlas, human atlas, is a beautiful guide to learn gross anatomy. You can get Professor Robert Acklands' collection online. You can also get it on archives on Telegram with some copyright restrictions. However, just type in the name and search in Telegram, you'll get archives that have a full collection of Professor Robert Acklands' human atlas of anatomy. The next tool we're going to be talking about in this video is Kaplan's Medical. Now, Kaplan's Medical was designed for the United States Medical Licensing Exam, Step 1 and Step 2. Here, I'm going to be talking about the Step 1 videos in particular. Kaplan's has a comprehensive collection from physiology, anatomy, biochemistry, pharm and parts, pediatric surgery, O&G, and internal medicine. So it's a full collection. And because of the comprehensive nature of Kaplan's Medical, it becomes a very valuable tool in your learning of medicine. Now, if you are a conservative student, you'll be very concerned about your textbooks and your notes from your lectures and all that. But you must realize that the learning of medicine is actually global and universal, and the knowledge of anatomy you are going to get in any part of the world is actually going to be the same. So it will be very valuable for you to open your mind to this kind of, you know, learning tools. From my experience, Kaplan's Medical is most appropriate for pharmacology, physiology, and biochemistry, and then less likely so for microbiology, histology, and other subjects. However, pharmacology, physiology, and biochemistry, and I'm going to mention wonderful teachers like Professor Tuko, Professor Leonie Raymond, Professor Fisher, and Professor K, who are very wonderful teachers who contributed to Kaplan. Kaplan Medical videos are available online with copyright restrictions, and they are also available in archives on Telegram, and you can check them out and use them to learn a lot of medicine. One of the advantages of Kaplan Medical is the comprehensive coverage of all the courses in your learning of medicine. The next I'm going to be talking about, which is probably the most popular worldwide amongst medical students, is Medical Lessons by Dr. Najib. Now, Dr. Najib is a Pakistani who resides in the United States. He's an excellent tutor. He has a wide collection of lectures from basic medical sciences to clinical sciences. Over 400 hours of, you know, lessons and contents are available for Dr. Najib. Dr. Najib also has an app where you can actually access all his lessons. You can get a lifetime access to all of his collections for, I think, $99, and is available online. I think one of the biggest drawbacks of Dr. Najib's lectures is that they are long. And of course, it is important that he takes time to explain this subject, because if you listen to his lectures, even with an IQ of 50, you're going to have an understanding of what he's talking about. But he takes a lot of time to be able to communicate his points across. However, in terms of detail and in terms of understanding, Dr. Najib stands out as one of the most excellent tutors in medicine worldwide, and we owe him a lot of gratitude for his good work. The next digital aid I'm going to be talking about is Osmosis. Osmosis is my favorite. Now, Osmosis has a wide range of collection that is available free online. There is also a prime version of Osmosis that is available on osmosis.org. And Osmosis is not just helpful for medical students, it's helpful for everybody in health sciences. Last time I checked, they have about 350 lessons that are available free on YouTube, and there is many more that are available in the prime version for Osmosis. I discovered Osmosis in medical school quite late. I discovered it when I was in my fifth year, but it was very helpful to learn pediatrics. It was very, very helpful also to learn internal medicine. Osmosis also has a good collection of pharmacology videos, biochemistry videos, and a wide collection of videos generally. However, most of these are available in the prime version of Osmosis. The prime version of Osmosis subscription is about $159 for a year, and various other prices for other years if you want to do the prime subscription for Osmosis. However, Osmosis has 5 stars from me. The next learning tool I'm going to be talking about in this video is that by Amando Hasadugan. Amando Hasadugan is a brilliant tutor. He started doing his video lessons even as a medical trainee. He has about 2 million subscribers on YouTube, and all his works are available online for free. You can also get collections in archives on Telegram. Amando Hasadugan has a wide coverage, and it spans across various subjects. He uses very interesting ways to communicate his points, flowcharts, diagrams, while at the same time explaining the nitty-gritty aspects of what you need to understand. Amando Hasadugan's videos are not as long as Dr. Najib, however, they are longer than Osmosis. Other very helpful channels where you can learn medicine online include Ken Hub, Ninja Ned, Lecturio, Anatomy Zone, and Khan Academy. Of course, there are a lot of YouTube videos that are available for discussing various subjects in medicine. However, these ones are the most comprehensive, and these ones are the ones that I have first-hand experience with. As a passing word, I'd like to say that there is a difference between having an understanding of the subject that you are learning and passing your exams. I've made videos on strategies you can use to pass your exams in medical school previously, and I'll drop the link here. But having an understanding of the subject you are learning is a different ballgame altogether. And these tools will help you have an understanding of the subject, and this is going to breed a lot of confidence in you. And this is very helpful when you are learning medicine. Now, if you're a conservative student and you believe in your textbook and your lectures, that is very fine. But these tools will set you on another plane in your learning of medicine. Thank you very much for watching to the end of this video, and I'm very grateful to all my subscribers. We just clocked 400 subscribers on YouTube. I'm excited to tell us that we're going to be starting a new series on this channel very soon, which is going to be Airside Bedside, where we're going to be discussing common cases that can be seen in the bedside across subspecialties in medicine, and it's going to be exciting. So thank you very much. Don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and see you in the next video.